Hello friends, my name is Karan and you are watching Plastotech, the world of plastics. So guys, our today's topic would be, I'll be discussing on what are the feed system, what are the components of the feed system and what is feed system. So guys, let's start our video. So before starting, I'm just requesting you to please subscribe our channel, press the bell icon and just share our videos. So guys, today I will tell you in detail how the feed system works, what are the components of the feed system and many more interesting or the main important things. The feed system plays vital role in injection molding machine. So just I am drawing a simple figure. This is called, I am just drawing a simple mold. You can see this rough sketch of a mold. So guys, this is your mold. This is the mold of injection molding machine. And I will I am going to show you how the entire function works. Now, this is your barrel of injection molding machine. This section. Now what happened? This is a channel where how the material flows inside the mold. I will show you each and every segment clearly. Just wait for a minute. This is the complete section. Now I'm going to describe you. This is the mold. This is the injection system of injection unit. This is the injection unit. This is how we are just inserting the material inside the mold. Now this particular section is called as sprue. This section where the material runs in your mold is known as, this section particular is known as runners. They are known as runners. And after the runners, the material, if sometimes there is also a subsection known as sub runners, and finally this particular point is called as gate point. Now I'm going to draw it alone. This is your product. Now listen, I'm going to show you a simple figure to completely illustrate you how what are the functions. Now listen, now this particular section where the material is injected inside the mold is called as sprue. Now guys, what is sprue? Sprue is that particular section from where the material is inserted inside your mold from the barrel. This is the path from where the material is directly inserted to your mold. Now what happened when the material is injected inside the mold, the material runs inside the mold. The channel, the path where the material runs is known as runners. These two sections are known as runners. In some type of what happened in some molds, there is also a sub-runner. Sub-runner means the part of a runner. This is also works just similar to runner. It's a part of, for example, if there is a tree, there are some branches over there. So the branches are the part of tree. So similarly, this sub-runner is a part of runner. Now at last, that is gate point. That is gate point. What happened at the gate point? The product is finally formed at this particular gate point. So this is your feed system of sprue, runner and gate. Finally, I'm going to show you directly right now how it looks. So just move to the video. So guys, hope you got the concept of sprue, runner and gate. This was an important topic, so I have told you. If you are new to our channel, old to our channel, do subscribe us, press the bell icon and stay connected with the Plastotech, the world of plastics. We will meet in the next video with some more interesting topics, some more knowledgeable topic. So stay connected. Thank you and have fun. So guys, as you can clearly see, this is the feed system. This section is called as feed system. Now this is sprue. Where I am showing my hand, this particular is known as sprue. Sprue is connected with the runners. You can see this. These are the runners.
this is particularly known as runners. And after that, there is also a sub-runner. You can see a thicker material, that is sub-runner. And it is called as cold slug well. Just opposite to the sprue is cold slug well. You can see this. This is a sprue which is connected to the barrel, and material just feeded from this sprue. And this section is connected with the barrel, and the material is feeded from this particular section. And after that, it started running through the runners. You can see that when the material is being after entering into your mold, they will run. The channel for running the material inside the mold are runners. You can clearly see that those are runners. And after that, there is sub runner also, and a gate point. You can see that gate point. This is gate point. At this particular point, your product will be formed. This point is called as gate point. There are this is four cavity mold. So you can see that there are four gate points. Four products are formed at a time. This is cold slug well. This is very important because cold slug well helps in just removing out the product and removing sometimes it helps in removing the sprue or removing out this particular channel. So this is very important. Cold slug well plays a vital role in just it just holds back this particular sprue, the complete feed system, and this helps in just ejecting out your product. So this is very important. Cold slug well plays a vital role in the ejection. So this was your channel, a simple how it now you can see that how the product this product is being formed similar fashion that I have told you how the function works. Similarly, this is a section from where the material goes. This is called as sprue, enters in your mold, and after that the material runs in this particular runners. You can see that this long area is called as runner. You can see clearly this is how the material, the plastic molten material, runs inside your mold with the help of this particular channel named as runner. After that, the material passes through sub runners. You can see that sub runners, and after sub runners, the material will just move to the gate point, and this is how the product is formed from the gate point. Hopes you got this concept. This is very easy concept, and a cold slug well is also been an important section of this complete feed system because it also plays a vital. Now I will show you something in the board that is very important. Let's understand what the concept says and how it works. So you can see that this is a section. I have just mentioned each and everything here. I have shown in a bigger way how the feed system works. Now you can see that this is a barrel of injection molding machine with a reciprocating screw. Now what happened? The material will be injected from this barrel to the mold. This is the barrel section, and the material, the plastic molten material, will insert in the mold from this particular section. Now you can see that this the way I have marked this section, the blackest section, that is called sprue. I have marked it as a sprue. You can see that sprue is a first way where the material from the barrel is inserted in the mold. So this is your sprue. At a particular point, you can see that how this sprue is formed. This is sprue. S-P-R-U-E. That is known as sprue. It is a first path from where the material is being inserted from your barrel inside the mold. Now you can see that this is a channel that I have drawn from the blue lines. This is called runners. This particular channel is called runner. That means runners are the channels which helps in running the molten material inside the mold. And this is sub runners, part of runners. Subrunners helps in transmitting the material similar to the runners. And this particular, now this is gate point. At a gate point, what happens? The product formation took place. So gate point is also an important. each and every section of feed system is important. Hopes in this entire video you have got the concept what does each and every section means and how it looks. Now I'll show you the at last there is a bluish in the bluish section. I have just made cold slug well. It is also very important section. You can see that this was an important video for feed system. I will tell you much more important sections, many more videos. So if you have been subscribed to our channel or you have not subscribed, do subscribe us and stay connected with us. And last, you can see that this bluish section is the dark bluish section is cold slug well. It help in just splitting out the material, the product, and many more other advantages of cold slug well is there. I will tell you in some other videos where I will just discuss about the concept of cold slug well.